What up, brothers? It's Clipper King returning for another repose video. I'm getting some requests through, but I've got to say, keep requesting if you like. It's not always going to make me do a certain figure faster, for the simple reason is I sometimes need to move one figure before I move another one, sort of thing. Also, you might notice every now and again that there'll be a figure that's been reposed that I've not showed you. That's because I think it's either going to be a bastard and it's going to take me like hours to do, and I can't do it while I'm filming. For example, the Batman. Repose that. Got his cape sorted out, finally. I repose the Spider-Man. I might do a more dramatic pose with Spider-Man at some point. So yeah, I think they're the ones I've done. Obviously, I did that bitch over here. I slightly changed his legs, brought them more forward after the thing. But basically, I told you how to do that anyway. The one I'm going to do tonight is that bad motherfucker in there. Sorry if you can see my reflection. Let me open the door. Be more professional, Rick, you fucking idiot. It's going to be Blade. I love that pose. I think the pose I'm going to put him in will be less dramatic, but I actually need that stand for someone else. So I'm going to get him back down. I'm going to pose him nice, just give you an idea. Because what's happening is, them three and Daredevil are going down to the bottom. And then Barney Ross, Indiana Jones and Jack Sparrow will be getting reposed and going into their slot. So, yeah, keep, like I said, request if you want, but I have got in mind the figures I want to do in what order. So I'll take the figure downstairs. And now here we are, Repose Central. This is the mothership, brothers. This is where the magic happens. First things first, you know we've got to put some tunes on. Don't want to be listening to fucking the sound of silence, do we? You know what I mean? This, if I'm not talking, could be very dull. So I'm going to play some tunes and hopefully you can jump on them. As you can see tonight, I'm going to play Neo's In My Own Words. That's Neo's first album. Do like a bit of R&B, a bit of soul, you know what I mean? Old stuff, new stuff, it's all good. You can fuck like a good into stuff like that, brothers. Young bucks. This is for grown folks I'm talking, so just cover your ears. But give that a little press. You fucking tell them, Neo. Right, rolling across, you know the figure we're doing. Tripod. Don't need to see that. I'm going to repose this badass. You know, I fucking love that pose. Now, I'm not got a pose in mind as such. I've a few little stances I want to go to. I'm going to go to a movie style pose because I've got a pose for the full shelf, if I'm honest. So it's not going to be too mental, but I need that stand for another figure. So I want him off that. I want him back on his own, and that's what I'm going to do. Got my beverage. I'll talk you through that in a bit. We'll get camera on tripod and we'll get cracking. Before we do that, let's have a look in tickle trunk, as Curtis likes to call it. It knew I was coming. Blade accessories, good to go. Right, we'll get camera on tripod and we'll get cracking.
Just stay with me, stay with me, stay with me.
I didn't get Excalibur art, forgive me brothers. Right, I'm in, like Flynn. I'm in there like swimwear. So, we're gonna do Blade. I'll just turn that a tiny bit so we can see what's fucking crack-a-lacking. Sure do. Right. Beverage of choice tonight, Morrison's. I hope you're listening. It's Morrison's own chocolate milkshake, and that, my friends, is beautiful. In fact, it's beautiful. If you get a chance to get onto this, do it. Nice and cold. Get a good shake. It's yummy yum. I'll have a little sip now just to make sure we're cooking on gas. Oh, that is a tasty treat. That's like melted ice cream. That is beautiful. Right, so I'm going to repose this. This is blasphemy, to be honest, because this is a pose I fucking love. Now, I photographed it enough, so I know I can get it back out like that. using this stand. What it is, I'm struggling for another stand like this, a flight post stand, and I want it for the daredevil figure, an idea I've got for that figure. And then I want Punisher and Wolverine as a four piece fucking gang of badasses, really. So I'm gonna split it down, make some changes on it, get a good clean, repose it. Could be an easy one. Another thing, I'm sorry that these videos run for a long time. I'll just explain why. I don't want to cut them and keep like slicing. I might put some cuts in, but that's only for me editing, that helps. I don't want you to miss anything, because the ideas come to me off at cuff as I'm doing stuff. Like when I get to these, I might decide I want to tell you something about them. So I don't want to be like, I don't want to be fucking about it, you know what I mean? I want to do it, you know what I mean? So, right, first let's get him off of you. Stand a clean. Getting back to a neutral pose like I always do. I'll get his guns out in his hands soon. Give everything a good clean. And have a look around him, make sure there's no damage has occurred while he's been up there. So for now, I'm going to break this stand down because it's going back in case until I get around to doing Daredevil. I will tell you, it's 3:15 in the morning, and Tess Jess, or Jess Tess, asked me the other day, do I ever sleep? I do sleep, but I sleep through daylight hours. Got a bit of blade in me, a bit of a fucking vampire. If I ain't got to get up for work next day, my body naturally fucking stays awake all night and sleeps all day. You can ask my Canadian brothers and my American brothers. They know I'm on Skype late into fucking wee hours. So that's that split down. Put that to one side. And like I said, I can use that for Daredevil when I get round to it. That's a figure. See, this is another one. This shows dust bad, this one. When I'm cleaning and all, I try and get all the fiddly bit off. So obviously I'm gonna take his sword out, I'm gonna take his sheath out. I thought I were, it's a bit stiff. Here we go. Take that out. There's no else that's, take his gigs off, his glasses. Just so I don't catch him and don't want no damage on Clipper King's figures. I'm not flush enough to buy multiples or to be replacing figures that I've already got. So I do like to be careful with them, treat them with respect that they deserve. The artist that put the time in on this don't want some clumsy-handed fuck like me bumping one off and fucking ruining it. Especially something like Blade that a lot of people will fucking kill for. This is a badass figure, this. This is one of them figures, what you call a sleeper figure. Come out, no fuss, nobody were raving about it like they are that Batman and that Joker. It, come out, we'll whimper it did. Sold out, lovely. Then what happened? Price went through the fucking roof and everybody wanted it. People did pick up on it but paid big bucks. Some people still want it but can't get hold of one. And I love a figure like that, especially if I've got it. So, right, I'm going to tip his accessories out. Look what he's got. Think of a pose. I also want to set his old stand up because that's what he's going on now. Don't look like there's been no damages done. No fucking marks in his coat that I can't do something about. It's going to be a matter of sort of getting his coat reposed, and I'm going to feature his coat in the pose I'm going to do. I'm thinking something like, I want him with his big Uzi type gun, sort of pulling his gun out from somewhere in there and holding this side of his coat open, mean and moody with his head in like a walking pose or a strutting pose. But also I want to put his guns back into their holsters, so I've got to show you how I'm going to do that. So what I'll do first is, I get his accessories out, get his stand set up, and then I mess about taking his guns out in his hands, taking his coat off, putting his guns into his holsters, and so on. I might be able to do that actually without taking his coat off, looking at it. Yeah, I think I can. A bit of skill from Clipper King might be able to do that with minimum fuss and effort. So right, let's get his stuff out. As I said, Curtis apparently says that this is what they call a tickle trunk. So it could be in Backsticks, where Curtis lives, out there in third world country, which is Canada, but in England it's Mary Poppins' accessory box. That's what it is, because it knows when I open that, it knows what to have ready for Clipper King to go in. You know what I mean? Don't have me lurking round. It knows. Fucking, it's a symbiote to my body. It knows what I'm thinking. That is clearly bullshit, brothers. It's just that I put them to the top when I know I'm posing something next. That's all it is. Sorry if I fooled you. Right. Nameplate stand. What am I going to do? Give a little waft with magic wand. Fucking Harry Potter thought he was magic. Not as fucking magic as that bastard. Look how easy it is to clean. No wet cloths. No. Just a nice soft number. What size are we on? 12mm. Nice soft 12mm paintbrush. Ideal. Can even get down into a little groove there, look. Get around nameplate. Never hurts, no, it don't. Never scratches it. It's beautiful. Bit of dust off at tops, you know it. Get that up. This is a nice stand, this one. Just rate cradle. Just rate width. Don't push his legs too wide open. He's not looking like a fucking oar. He's beautiful, this one. Okay, stand set up. Not putting his bomber jacket on. I'm basically looking. Don't want them. I want his Uzi. His modified Uzi, should I say. I think I'm going to put that in one hand. I want an hand that will hold his coat open. So probably that one. Going to be holding it with left hand. Grabbing his gun with right. So he's got his gun hand on that side. So I'll start taking his guns out now. So I want that hand on. That's one gun out. Magazine came out. Just make sure you don't drop and lose them. Because these guns are blades. They're beautiful. And this hand can come off altogether. Ooh, little bounder. It's very tight, that hand. I like it tight, but not that tight. This pose could be the first anti-climax pose ever. Because after Batman 1 I did, people are saying, what the fuck are you touching your blade figure for? Leave it, it's pretty much perfect, and I agree with him, it is. But variety, my friends, is the spice of life. So what I'm going to do now, I'm going to try and get his guns inside his coat. Now, with this pose I want to do, I pretty much want him looking streamlined. I don't know if I want his... I don't know if I want his harnesses on him or if I want to take them off. In fact, decision made. I'm going to take his harnesses off for this one. So I've took both his hands off. I'm going to take his coat off right quick. Take his harnesses off because I don't want him looking too bulky under arm because it might kill the lines at pose. So I'm going to take his coat off nice and fast. Ah. Now I've got to open his belt to take that off. I'm sad and slow, walking out and off the radio. Come on, Babby. That's one side off. Oh, no. Oh, no, it's all right. We're all right, we're good to go. I just didn't want it to bring his stakes off if I took his, if his harness off. I don't want his stakes to come off. But they won't, I don't think. But it's just a bit of a fucking bastard to get off. So, just have to bear with me on this one, gents. Like I said, I never want to fucking bust out, so I have to take everything easy. Bring this side around. I think it's going to be better. It's just the cutest thing. Oh, it's a bastard, this. Have a look. What it is, his harnesses, they attach to his belt as well, so you've got to get them off. Yeah, Bobby, we've got it now, look. So his shoulder harness is now off. I'm just going to put his belt back round him. That'll hold his stakes in place. So, that's what we're gonna do. Click his belt back in. click. That's it, that's them in. Get them up in nice position. Like I said, that strap there attaches to his belt, and his shoulder harnesses, they click onto his belt as well, or his belt sort of runs through him. So, I didn't want them, because what they do is, because they're on his sides here, they puff out the side of his jacket, and I don't want it. I want him to look sleek in this pose, so I've took his harnesses off. Now his coat, while it's off, what I'm gonna do is, I'm gonna try and put like a forced crease back into the side. Let me show you. What I'm gonna do, I'm gonna reposition it like it's come out of box, brand spank. Put the crease back through there, because it's been spread, remember, when it were on the original pose. So yeah. There's no wire through this coat, but because of material, it is a pretty stiff one. So I'm just gonna make sure it's crisp. All the creases, look. You see that, it's a little bit wishy-washy, that one. What I'm gonna do, finger and thumb, just nice, tight. Just rub through it, just to get the sharpness through his collar. Look at that, nah. Look what you've done, Clipper. Got it looking beautiful. Right then. So, we'll get his coat back on. Might be able to do this one fast. That's what I was saying. Yeah, I'm cutting these videos, and I looked at last one, I'm like, fucking hell, 45 minutes. I'm thinking, nobody's gonna watch a video 45 minutes long. They get a bit bored to fuck. And then I watch it, but I'm thinking to myself, well, it's interesting, I suppose, if you're into posing your figures. Maybe people will start watching it, and then now on YouTube, if you start watching a video, then you come back to it, it'll put you back to where you got to last time. So I'm thinking they might all watch it once in a few settings. I've just come off Skype, and Curtis told me he's watched that Batman video every night since it's been on, all the way through. And I'm like, Curtis, it's 45 minutes. He's saying, yeah, but I love the figure, and I like how you pose it, and I like the things you say. I'm like, well, thanks for your commitment, brother, but I never expected anybody to watch it that amount of times. And for all the multiple viewers out there, thanks a lot, brothers, because you must be liking what I say, or the way I say things, or whatever it is, for you to go back and watch a 45 minute video more than once, because to be honest, I don't even know if I've watched it all the way through yet. So another little sip. Like I say, I had a Pepsi, if you remember, on the last video, and Pepsi's still not contacted me, so I don't really like to shout people out for endorsements, but this one is Morrison's. It's Morrison's own make, and Morrison's are big chains of supermarkets in England, so I bet it won't hurt them to slip me a couple of £100 every now and again, just for a figure, every now and again, and I keep drinking the shakes, or just send me shakes. It'd be nice, because let's have a little sip. Oh, feels like a fresh pint of bull's milk, just rolling down your throat. Beautiful. Right, let's get his hands on. Let's get these fucking hands on. So I want a left to hold his coat open, I said, didn't I? Which will be that one, methinks. Like I said, I've gone for that one. Slightly open, not a lot, just so that he can grab his own coat. Hold it open, so it'd be something like that. Can you see? Attach his hand, open it, and as if he's pulling his Uzi out from somewhere here. That's what I'm gonna try and do. Might look shit, if it does, we can change it, brothers, can't we? We're in no rush. Not gonna get up for out in morning. Brother's coming through and everything, bringing his kids. So that's as good a reason as out to stay in bed. You know what I mean? I'm a man of people. Just don't like to get up too early. So I'm gonna be saying to me, brother, look, don't come through fucking early hours at morning. Don't come through at like 10 o'clock. Come through about 2 in the afternoon when Clipper King's fresh. You know what I mean? Come and spend day with your brother, your big brother, but don't come too early waking me up. My eyes will be like fucking sheep's fannies, full of wool. Right, gun hand for other one, because his Uzi's going in it. Right hander blade, I'm thinking. Doesn't seem to be a keggy to me, so that's what we're going with. Right handed gun. Get on. She's on. She goes on nice. Sorry if Neo's getting a bit rowdy in corner, but we do like a bit of Neo. Like I said, I do like this R&B and soul style music. What I'm gonna do is get his And I get his... I don't know if anybody knows. If you look at the back of this figure, I can't show you now, I don't think. If you look on his... Look at the back, you see that little catch here? What happens is... He's got a triangular shape on his back here, on his coat, look. And what you do is, you drop his sword through that. He's got like a button here on his sword. That button drops into the little catch and it stays in place, and it's a fucking awesome idea. So, got that in. Just gonna check it, so I don't want it flopping about, because that will not look good. Ah, come on. He's in now. And I'll put his sword in a minute. So, like I said, I'm just trying to make sure that his coat is nice and tight to him in this pose. And obviously I've got his shurikens there, they open up these, they'll come out and open up. So again, it's not gonna fit that flush to him. But I'm thinking it's gonna be flush enough. He's gonna look mean, don't worry about it. Don't worry about it too much. I'm gonna put his Uzi in his trigger hand. You can see, done. This is a beast of a gun, this. Beast. So, I want to make sure I've got his wrist articulation as I want it. So I want him sort of like that. Alright, now I'm trying to get his coat in and his eyes. In fact, what I'm going to do is I'm just going to put a slight pause in there just for editing reasons. So yeah, I've just got his hand in now holding his coat, and I'm sort of going for something like that. He's got this hand holding his coat, and I could have it pulling it really wide. I'm going to have a look. I want to see that bit of red, actually, because it'll contrast nice with the black when it's in cabinet. And then with this hand, just sort of coming across him, pulling out the Uzi. As if his Uzi's been attached here, it hasn't, but I want it to look like that. So for now, because I'm basically just adding bits and bobs on him, adjusting his legs, I'm going to put him on his stand. See, this one is one that I want to look as natural as possible. I don't want it mental, I want it flowing lines. Just putting some creases through the bottom of his coat. Like I say, there's no wire in it, but it will hold because it's like a stiff leather feel, like a pleather sort of thing. Put his sword in his back. I know you can't see it in a minute, boys, but you will get a good look at it. Careful when you put that in, you don't want to break that because it's a key piece to the blade figure. Just make sure. Fucking it's come out of catch. Bastard, because I've got to try to withstand that. Sorry, gents. Gotta get that back in now. Sorry, remember there is frustrations with these figures. That's fucking part of them. Please don't fuck about on me, Blade. Blade's fucking cult. Fact. We're in, and now I've put it to the side so I can tilt it so it will come over his right shoulder. That's how I want to see it. You'll know what I mean when I show you. And because I'm putting some dip in his head, if you catch him from an angle, you're gonna see his awesome tattoo on the back of his neck. You'll see this, innit? Don't you worry about it. And I think you might like it, but you might say, Rick, what you changed it for? You might do, we'll see. So we've got his coat open, that is nice. Still need to look natural. Fucking hell, I might have only gone and done it again, brothers. Oh, I tell you what, just look. Look. Look at him and enjoy him. Look how I've got him. If he's looking towards camera there, you can see this coming over his shoulder. I've not got it straight up and down, slightly lent over, so it's going diagonal across his back. So you're just catching, you know he's got his sword. Let me just rotate him at that distance. Rotate him this way for you. Look, as he goes round. As he goes round, enjoy him. Catch a look at that tattoo. See, that's why I've got his head dipped. See more of his tattoo as it comes round. See how his sword's got movement across it. Again, look, tattoo all the way round. Beautiful. Look at him, every angle. Sweet as fuck. And as I move it away, skier a little. He's walking. Look how he's holding that coat away, so it's nice. You can see he's red for his coat. I'm going to bring this side round when I get him posed upstairs. So you not see the red on that side, but you see it. Might even put a bit of... put a bit of that on it. Like that. Oh, fucking hell, what? Look at that now. Look what I've done. What I've done to it. Just flailing out like that. Beautiful. Bit of wind coming across him. Beautiful. And that, strategically, as that's blowing away, you can see his fucking stainless steel spikes. Look down here. Look at it. Look what I've done. Fucking hell, Batesy. Jesus. Legs not too dramatic. Might tidy them up a tiny bit. So I can get a bit of, and just sort his trousers out as well so they ruffle up nicely. But I am feeling that. Ain't got no thoughts to play away for me to say. And girl, you are off the chain. Oh, nice. When I show you that from angle, I want you to see it. I think you'll agree, brothers, that is very nice. Very nice indeed. I'm not gonna do no more than that. I'm happy with what I've got there. Let me bring him in. Let me bring him in so you can see it. So what I'm gonna do, I'm gonna have a little slurp and then I'm gonna put him on this box and I'm gonna show you. Oh. That milk is very tasty. Morrison's white chocolate milk. That's the label you want, boys. And this one, that's a litre, that. That is a litre. It is very tasty. Very Moorish. It's like heroin. It's very Moorish. Right, let's stand him on tickle trunk. Let me get that camera. Let me get that camera off. Quick release. Like a transformer it is. Let's have a look. That's where I want you to see him from. Look at that. Just fucking look at it, will you please? Clipper, Gio, fucking hell. Well, just bragging you, you cunt. That is, I like that. Not as dramatic as first pose. No kidding. You don't need to be. It says it all. Look at lines in coat. Even folds are fucking where they need to be. Oh, Batesy, lad. You're too much. You're definitely too much. But let me go upstairs, get him under the lights, get him back with Wolverine at Punisher, and we'll wrap this bad boy up. Right, here he is, back in cabinet with his chums. Just show you what they all look like together. That's all three. Sorry if it's a bit dull, I'm filming sort of into the light. Can't wait actually to get them down into the bottom of the cabinet where I'm going to keep them. So they've got a little bit more room each. Because the Blade and Punisher at front seem to cover up Wolverine a little bit too much, but that won't be the case when it's done and dusted, so you have to stick with me for that. I'll show you when it's done. But I do kind of like the Blade pose. That's him. It's another repose video, brothers, done and dusted. I'm thinking about Jack Sparrow next, if I'm honest. I might change yet, but I'm not sure. But for now anyway, this is the Clipper King, and I'm out of here.